Hello everyone, this is Marcia Melendez, real estate entrepreneur and motivator. So, you're thinking of selling your home. Good luck to you. Selling your home is one of the most important and most stressful things that you will ever have to undertake. But with pre-planning, it can go so much easier. Stay tuned and we're going to take a look at it. You know, once you decide to sell your home, a thousand things comes into your mind. But this is where pre-planning comes into place. First of all, a lot depends on why you're selling your home. Are you retiring? Are you looking to move into a bigger house because your children are outgrowing the home you're in now? Are you downsizing, moving into a condo, moving out of state? So many different factors come into play. But once you've decided to make that leap, there are a number of things that you should do before you actually put your home on market. First thing you need to know is to know where you're going and plan accordingly. If you're going to move out of state, have you purchased your new home? If you're downsizing in the same neighborhood, have you found something you like? Are you going to be moving into a condo? Can you afford to purchase your next home without having the proceeds from the sale of this house? So many things to think about. Can you afford to pay two mortgages? If you're purchasing another property and your current home doesn't sell fast enough, you may need to think about that. Are you going to be able to put your things in storage while the house sells? Are you going to be able to live with relatives? So all the things that you have to think about before you actually start thinking about putting that home on market. If you are purchasing a new home in the same area or even out of state, I usually recommend that you work with a mortgage broker to see what your options are, especially if you need the proceeds of one home to put towards the other one. Mortgage brokers are pretty savvy and they'll be able to tell you the best way to go about it. Also, the best way to sequence the events so that you don't end up spending too much money on relocation costs or, as I said before, having to pay two mortgages if your home doesn't sell in time. Once you've done that, the next thing you need to do is to look at your market conditions, just the ones in your immediate neighborhood as well as in your city. You know, real estate is very hyper-local, and what is occurring in one area of the state is not necessarily going to occur with you. So you need to look around your neighborhood. Start looking on those sites, you know, Zillow, Street Easy, and see what the homes in your area are going for and comparing them to your home. You know, is this a buyer's market? Is this a seller's market? Is the market neutral? All these things go into play when you're thinking of putting your home on sale, because the next point I want to make, what is most important is pricing it correctly. So if you don't know what else is going on in your neighborhood and how the other homes are selling, how will you know how to price your home? Now, you know, a lot of us think our homes are absolutely fabulous, but how we see our home and how others see it can be completely different. You have to be honest with yourself. Look at the homes in your neighborhood. If something else is selling for $850,000, I'm in New York City, guys. What is it about their home that would command such a price? Is it a multifamily dwelling? Has it been recently redone with new kitchens, new bathrooms, a new roof, wonderful landscaping? And compare it to your home. What is your home lacking that this home has? So these are the factors that you need to take into account and be honest with yourself. If you price your home too high, it's going to be such a big disservice to yourself. First of all, the first 2 weeks that a home goes on market is when the most activity occurs. If your home is priced too high, nobody's going to want to look at your home. It's going to sit there for a week or two. Then people are going to wonder, why is your home sitting there when everything else has a lot of activity? I don't know where you live, but here in Brooklyn and in the city, things are turning around pretty fast. Even though the home market for condos is very high, for single family homes, we don't have that much choice. Remember, when you look at how the other homes have been selling in your area, listing price is not always the same as selling price. So you need to take that into account. The next thing you need to do is to take an unbiased look at your home. Be honest. Identify any areas that need repairs. You know, if you have the money, the best thing you could do is to get a pre-inspection of your home. Normally people get inspections when they're purchasing, but if you're thinking that your home might need some repairs, it's a good thing to know that beforehand. Why? Number one, you could decide to do the repairs yourself. Or if it needs a whole lot of renovations, you might say, look, I just want to get out of here, and you price the home accordingly so that the buyer knows what they have going into the sale and sell it as is. So these are some things that you really need to take a look at. I usually recommend that it doesn't need major renovations. There's always things you can do to improve your home. Remember, when somebody comes to see it, something that might cost you $100, $200 to repair, they might want to put a $1,000 figure on it. For instance, painting your front door, replacing the fixtures in your bathroom if they're old, adding new carpet in the living room. Some of these things might, when you tally them up, might come up to about $1,000, but it could end up adding another $5,000 to the ultimate sale price of your home. So look at that and be honest with yourself and think about what repairs you can do now and what repairs you're going to leave for the new owner. Another thing you have to do is declutter. Declutter, and did I say declutter? This is one of the major obstacles that I have found when I'm going out with new buyers and they're looking at homes. You know, people go into a house, some buyers don't have any imagination. I'll be honest, because I've taken buyers out and they say, oh, I hate that color. You're not buying the color of a house. But one thing that does make a big difference and that they usually complain about is when the rooms are too small. And a lot of times it's not because the room is so small, it's just that it has so much stuff in it. You know, we Americans like to collect stuff. Well, when you're selling your home, that's the opportune time to get rid of a lot of things. If there are things that are dear to you, pack them up. Get some big barrels and big containers from Home Depot and pack up a lot of things. I've gone into homes and on every counter, on every surface, there's something. Somebody goes into a situation like that and the first thing they think, oh, this kitchen is too small. There's no counter space. Well, it's not that there's no counter space. It's just that the present homeowner has something on each counter in the kitchen. So please, declutter as much as you can. It's a great way to start packing and to start getting ready for your next move anyway. Think about your closets. People are going to open your closets because, you know, we're always concerned about closet space. You don't want when they open the closet that things are falling out. Take out half your stuff and pack it away. That's the best advice I can give you. That is so important. Another thing in this area that you have to remember is that 90% of homes these days are seen online before the potential buyer even comes to your property. And you know how photos are. They tend to just bring out the worst in you. You know, photos put on 10 pounds on a person, right? So you can imagine if your house is a mess and then you're taking photographs or videos, it just looks worse. I've seen things for sale on the market with the bathrooms where they could have just added a little bit of fresh grout, would have made a big difference. Or they take photos with the toilet seats open. Could you imagine? So think about this. Walk around your house. Think about what you can remove and what small things that you could do to make the house more appealing. All these things add up to a quick sale. And remember, that's what we're looking for. Final thing you need to do is to decide whether you're going to hire a realtor or sell the home by yourself. I'm a realtor and we have always used another realtor whenever purchasing or selling property. But some people feel they can do it on their own. Yes, there are disadvantages and advantages to both methods. But whatever you need to do, think about it before so that when you actually go through the process, it will be a lot less stressful. I have given some tips that you can find in the link below, whether you're selling the home yourself or whether you're going to work with a realtor. There's some good advice there for you. Please remember to subscribe. I need some more subscribers on my channel. Take care, and I'll see you next time.